I've never been a big fan of Perlon. While I love the way they look, I just never warmed up to them. I much prefer the feel of a good leather or NATO strap. Plus, Perlon's never seemed quite as secure as I'd like. Well, earlier this year, Armilla put out a new type of Perlon strap, and one that's a bit different, where you can switch between wearing them as a traditional single strap or double it up like a NATO. And a few months ago, the owner Andre contacted me and asked if he could give me a set to try out. Now, so far, I've been impressed with everything else Armilla's put out, and the color he's chosen for these Perlons are awesome, so I thought it was time to give Perlon another look. First off, let's go over how they convert from a single strap to a NATO. And it's pretty straightforward, and that's all thanks to the buckle used here, as there is a secondary loop it goes through. Now, they all start off as a single strap, well, sort of a single strap. As you can see here, there is a bottom strap section and a loop. It's just pretty short here to start out with. So to convert it to a NATO, you just feed some of the strap through the top to create some slack. Then pull that through the bottom and secure everything up. And there you go, it's basically a NATO. Although there will be some trial and error here, just to get it the right length for each watch. It's a pretty simple concept, and kinda cool that you can do it, especially since you can customize it for each watch. And that's really the strength of a Perlon anyways, as there are no set holes and you can change it up perfectly for your wrist. However, there are some downsides to this. And the first is that when it's set up like a NATO, you only have one loop to feed the excess strap through, so it's not quite as convenient. And since you do need a longer strap just for this whole process, when it was set up for a single strap, I thought there was a lot of excess that needed to be tucked in for my 7-inch wrist. And because of that, I just wind up leaving these set up like a NATO anyways, rather than going back and forth. Now, I really like Armilla's seatbelt style NATOs. Not only are they extremely comfortable, but the colors available aren't the typical ones everyone else has. And Andre went the same direction when picking out colors for these Perlons. Now, first off, you have the red burgundy color. And while I love this color, I did have a harder time finding the right watch to match it to. That is, until I tried it on my brand new Seiko 5, where it just looked fantastic next to the gray dial. Although, the green one looked pretty good too. Now, out of the four, I think the green is the most traditional colors, and probably would be the most versatile. But after putting it on this green diver, I really didn't want to take it off. It just matched it perfectly. Next, we have the blue, which is a lighter blue color, and it seemed to show off the texture of the Perlon the best. And here, it did look pretty good on my khaki king, but I think it looked best on the white dial Vario Empire, as it perfectly matched the dial texture and the color of the hands. Last, we have the more unusual color choice, and that's listed as Diver's Orange, which depending on the light either looks like neon or a burnt orange. And when it looks like a burnt orange, it's perfect for any alumni of UT. Now, even though it looks a little odd, I think it looked perfect against the blue dial, where I had it on both my Orion TriStar and the Zelos Mako 3. So as you can see, no matter which color strap you choose, they all look great. However, how they look is nowhere near as important as the quality and how they feel on your wrist. Now, I've only had a few other Perlons in the past, and those have all been less expensive $15 ones off Amazon. And comparing these to those, I'd say that this is more of a premium style Perlon, which is reflected in the price. These are listed at $32 normally, but they're currently on sale for $25, plus there is a 15% discount code for the channel as well. Now, with Armilla's Perlon, they do seem to have a better material, as well as a much tighter weave, and I think that results in it being softer and more comfortable on the wrist. They are still a bit stiff, but they do break in rather quickly. The hardware also seems to be of a better quality, yet the needle is still a bit narrower than I'd like, but maybe appropriate considering the tight weave. I don't think they want to stretch this out as much. Overall, these Perlons are pretty comfortable to wear. They're thin, lightweight, and very breathable, which really is what people like about Perlons to begin with. Now, I still prefer a Nado, but I am warming up to these, especially now while it's very hot and very humid out. So bottom line, these are some great straps, and by far better than some of the cheaper ones out there. If you're a fan of Perlons, then I think these are worth taking a look. But if you're not a fan, well, I don't think these are going to convert you in any way. They are great straps, but at the end of the day, they're still Perlons. Well, that about wraps it up. Now, as always, let me know down below what you think about these, or if you know of some other great straps I should try out. And as always, if you enjoyed the video, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Till next time.